I think I'm almost convinced at this point that the Black Widow movie was tanked on purpose by the Phantom Menace. The fact that the Phantom Menace saw the score was going up and up, so they tried to tank the score as low as possible, which is down to a 6.8 now, basically. And yeah, we all know the Phantom Menace hates Black Widow. We all know they completely despise Black Widow for absolutely no reason. They all loved the movie when the first trailer came out, but it's coming out now, so and we can't wait. We don't like women, so it's but I want it's a and the irony is that parts of the Phantom Menace are women, but again, they want women to be all in sexual roles, which is completely and utterly stupid and just retarded. Okay, I wish they would realize that women are not objects. They don't understand that. And they probably will never understand that, because that's how they see women in movies. That's how they think women in movies should be treated, which is stupid and dumb. But yep, this is basically, there. And yeah, this movie takes place at the Civil War, so some people were disappointed in this movie because they didn't explore her backstory enough. They sold her as a kid, and her parents escaping the government to Cuba, basically. Because they were already in the Red Room, and they basically were controlled by this old Russian guy who also brainwashed his daughter as well into being the bad guy of the movie. Of course, the Phantom Menace threw a hissy fit about that, but it actually really ties into the storyline of this movie, where this guy is basically controlling all these women to turn them into mindless drones. And yeah, I do not understand. The only thing I don't really understand is how this movie cost $200 million to make, and Shang-Chi cost $150 million to make. That just makes no sense to me. This movie cost $200 million to make. Okay, it looks like a movie that would cost $150 to $100 million to make, but how? But $200 million? I get there are COVID troubles and troubles with the COVID virus, but $200 million to make? I bet that includes all the reshoots they had to do because of COVID. All the delays, delays do cost money. When Shang-Chi was, I think Shang-Chi was also delayed a lot as well, but the Phantom Menace threw a massive fit in this movie. And no, Black Widow did not flop at all, okay? Where was your notion, okay, that Black Widow was the big flop of the year, okay? But they were complete, and again, they completely ignored Space Jam: A New Legacy flopping. They actually praised that movie for beating Black Widow, and male gaze wins again. Okay? I did not buy this movie for quote unquote male gaze. I watched this movie because I like Marvel, I like the character of Black Widow, so I watched the movie. It's actually good. I don't care what the fucking Phantom Menace says. I don't care what they say, because their opinions don't matter to me, because it's not my. Because my opinion is the one that I'm telling you, not the Phantom Menace's opinions, which, again, they completely trashed this movie because they said Black Widow's feminist, Black Widow's horrible, therefore it's bad movie. She doesn't have big enough, Scarlett Johansson doesn't have big enough tits in this movie. So, 0 out of 10, don't watch, basically. That's basically like the Phantom Menace, every typical Phantom Menace when they see a woman that has strong. That's strong and isn't using their body for other means. But yeah, now we're talking about the now we're talking about other things now as well. Okay, so yeah, basically they saw a bit about the childhood, but this movie takes place after the Civil War. Well, she's running away from the government, and now, and she meets her sister, and they saw a small backstory of her sister as well, all grown up too, and she has to stop the Red Room, who in this movie could basically destroy the entire world by ending by starting World War III and nuclear war. I think that's pretty good. That's pretty cool that, that's the despite there being no real stakes in this movie because the character is dead, they really do put stakes in this movie because, hey, if we don't stop this guy, he has control over all these people. So basically, if someone tries to stop him or stand up to him, if you let him get away, he could end the whole world. And basically, they do the story of the Red Room and all the Black Widows, Alfrey. This is actually the story, the movie was actually very similar to the plot lines as well. But there were, I didn't really see anything about Black Widow trying to steal stuff from S.H.I.E.L.D. That was a part of the Black Widow leaks. I didn't, there wasn't really anything a part of that. It just showed her, them as kids, and then the government was after them, and the government basically like, oh, no, 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 we have to stop it. The government is, you know, basically, the government's trying to kill us because we are assassins. That's basically what the first part of the story is. But yeah, there was no scene of Black Widow before the, you know, all grown up before the Avengers, like the leaks described it, stealing stuff from S.H.I.E.L.D., and that's why, you know, she is bad. No, that's because this movie takes place during Civil War, and this movie takes place after Civil War, and the governments are all after her because he broke the Sokovia Accords. And, yeah. And after this movie, despite, you know, saving the world again, she's still considered a threat to world. And, yeah, that leads to the events of Infinity War. There's also a scene at the end where her sister, you know, is at her grave, because, of course, he dies in Endgame. And, of course, this movie also leads into the Hawkeye movie, apparently, because Hawkeye is apparently blamed for Black Widow's death, even though they were literally fighting in Endgame who's going to die, who wants to die first. They should do a what-if episode about what if Hawkeye died instead of Black Widow. What would be the difference, basically, if that happened? But, yeah, there we go. The Phantom Menace is dumb. You know, basically, there are a bunch of crybabies. You know, and yeah, this movie wasn't that bad. You know, probably one of the better movies of, you know, there. And yeah, they saw the sweetest movie all in the theaters, and I bet it would have done way better at the box office. It would probably open to $100 million at the box office. Look at Saint C is doing pretty well in the theaters. And, you know, people don't, and, you know, instead of, you know, splitting 50-50 with Disney Plus and theaters, which is how it was at the worldwide box office, which means it likely made $375 million on Disney Plus as well, which is no surprise at that at all. So, yeah. Goodbye.